गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ जयंत सरदाना, केमिस्ट्री फैकल्टी इन श्री चैतन्य घोषाला कैंपस। तो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम नॉमनक्लेचर टू आइसोमेरिज्म। सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन नॉमनक्लेचर, सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन कॉमन नेम्स, स्ट्रक्चरल आइसोमेरिज्म, देन स्टीरियो आइसोमेरिज्म। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द करेक्ट आईयूपीएसी नेम ऑफ द अल्केन। सो अल्केन इज गिवन, वी हैव टू राइट द करेक्ट आईयूपीएसी नेम। सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द नेम, so name contains first word root, after that what is written, primary suffix, then secondary suffix, and before word root what is written, primary prefix and secondary prefix. So if we consider what is word root, word root we indicate total number of carbon atoms in parent chain. For example, if one carbon atom is present, word root will be meth. For two carbon atoms, eth. For three carbon atoms, prop. Four carbon, but. Five carbon, pent. And six carbon, hex. So same, next will be hept, oct. So this word root will represent that how many carbon atoms are present in parent chain. And what is parent chain? Longest continuous chain of carbon atoms in alkane will be considered as parent chain. Now primary suffix will represent about alkane, alkene and alkyne. So ane and I. And secondary suffix will represent if any functional group is present. You know, for example, alcohol, carboxylic acid, for different functional group, different secondary suffix is used. Primary prefix is used for cyclic compounds. And which prefixes are used? A simple cyclic compound, one ring, cyclo. For bicyclic compounds, bicyclo. And one is spiro. Okay. So primary prefix is only used if a compound is cyclic, otherwise it is not used. Now secondary prefix is used for substituents. Now what are substituents? Carbon atoms which are not included in the parent chain are considered as substituent, or you can say branch chain. For example, one carbon atom CH3, methyl, ethyl. So every alkyl group which is not in parent chain is written in secondary prefix. And halogen atoms like fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo, nitro. So all these will be considered as substituent and their name will be written in secondary prefix. So this is general structure of the name. Now if we consider this compound, what will be the length of the parent chain? This is parent chain. How many carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 carbon atoms are in parent chain. Now next is numbering. Numbering is done in such a way so that the substituent will get the least number. How many substituents are present here? 2 substituents. So if we write numbering from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what number we get? 3, 5. If we write from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, same, 3, 5. So, two substituent methyl are present at which position? 3 and 5. So, 3, 5 dimethyl and 7 carbon atom is heptane. So, which option will be correct? C option. So, this is simple question of nomenclature of alkane. Now, move to next question. Now, some substituents are attached fluoro, iodo, bromo, nitro. And what is written here? ET. ET is ethyl in C2H5. So, if we expand this structure, carbon, hydrogen, fluorine, iodine, NO2, and here what is present? CH2, CH3. So this is ethyl group. Now what will be the length of parent chain? This 4 carbon atoms are present in parent chain. Now next, numbering. If you know numbering from this end, at first carbon what we get? 2 subsequent. So from here numbering will start 1, 3, 4. Now total 4 substituents are present. One is fluoro, iodo, bromo and nitro. And these substituents will be arranged in alphabetical order. So which will come alphabetically first? Bromo. So what we have to write? 2 bromo. Now from options if you check, there is only one option where 2 bromo is written. So what will be answer here? 2 bromo. Next is 1 fluoro, 1 iodo, 2 nitro, And for four carbon atoms, what is word root? Bute. For single bond, what is written? Ane. So butane. So this is name of the compound. Remember this, whenever more than one substituents are present, we have to arrange those substituents in alphabetical order in secondary prefix. So we have arranged in alphabetical order, bromo, next is fluoro, next is iodo, next is nitro. And for four carbon atom, word root will be butane. So which option is correct? Option C is correct answer. Now next, move to next question. What is written? The structure of isobutyl. Now this is question from common name. Now this is very important. How to write common names of alkyl group? So if we consider about isoalkyl. So for isoalkyl, hydrogen is removed from isoalkane and from end carbon opposite to branching. And for example, if we have to draw isobutyl, first we have to draw isobutane, then we remove hydrogen from the end carbon opposite to the branching. Same isopentyl, if we have to write, first we have to draw isopentane. So let us first discuss about isoalkanes. Very easy to draw isoalkane. N minus 1 carbon atom should be attached in parent chain, in straight chain, and one methyl branching will be present at second position. So butane contain total how many carbon atoms? 4. So if we arrange N minus 1, so 3 carbon atoms are arranged in straight chain and one methyl branching at which position? Second position. So this is isobutane. Now we have to remove hydrogen from the end carbon opposite to branching. Now both are same, both are opposite to the branching. So remove one hydrogen. What do you get? CH3, CH2, one hydrogen is removed. So this will be the structure of isobutyl. So how to draw isoalkyl? First we have to draw isoalkane and then we have to remove hydrogen from the end carbon opposite to the branching. So let us find out which option is correct. Now if you check this, what is written? This is secondary butyl. We'll tell you from options also. Because hydrogen is removed from the secondary carbon. So this is secondary butyl. Now if we consider B option, this is normal butyl. Hydrogen is removed from normal butane, all four carbon atoms in straight chain, and from the last carbon atom. Now if we consider this, hydrogen is removed from which carbon? Tertiary carbon. So this is tertiary butyl. And if you check, this is structure for isobutyl. So 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms in chain, second carbon methyl branching, and what is present here? CH3. So CH2. Numbering we do not write, because for complex substituent numbering we have to write from the this carbon, first, second, third. But if you consider this, it is formed from CH3, CH, CH3, CH3. From isobutane we have removed one hydrogen, so what is formed? Isobutyl. So which option is correct? Option D. So for common names, refer your notes for isoalkane, neoalkane, how to draw these structures. Now next is IUPAC name of the compound. Now if you check, this is a alkene, because what is present here? Double bond. Now first rule is selection of parent chain. In case of unsaturated compounds, alkenes and alkynes, we have to select the parent chain which contains unsaturation. And it is not necessary that it will be always longest chain, means more number of carbon atoms. But important is we have to consider unsaturation in the parent chain. Second is that double bond or triple bond will get higher priority than the substituents, like these alkyl groups, fluoro, chloro. So while numbering, always double bond or triple bond will get the higher priority. So if we consider parent chain, so double bond will get number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many carbon atoms are in parent chain? 6 carbon atoms. If you consider this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, same, having how many substituents? 2 substituents. If we consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but it contain only one substituent. So if two chain of equal length are possible, then we have to consider that chain in which more number of substituents are attached. That's why we have considered this, because how many substituents are present if you consider two substituents? One is at third position and one is at fourth position. At fourth position, how many carbon atoms? Two. So this substituent is ethyl. At third, what is present? Propyl. So these two substituents are present at third, propyl. At fourth, what is present? Ethyl. So if we write name, first we have to arrange this ethyl and propyl in alphabetical order. So which will come alphabetically first? Ethyl. So it will be 4-ethyl. At third carbon, what is present? Propyl. Now, what is word root for 6th carbon atom? Hex. And double bond is present at first position. So, hex 1-ene. So, which option will be correct? Option A. 4-ethyl, 3-propyl, hex 1-ene. Now, let's move to next question. The correct structure of. Now, name is given, but we have to draw structure. Now, it is very important, whenever his name is given and we have to draw structure, always first represent the parent chain. Now, what is given? Word root bute. Bute means how many carbon atoms? 4. So, represent 4 carbon atoms. Next, what is present? Ene at which position? First position. So, this will be double bond at first position. We will write numbering 1, 2, 3, 4. Then, we have to write substituents which are present. At fourth carbon, what is present? Bromo. And at third carbon, what is present? Methyl. So, CH3. Now, this will be the structure 4, 4 bromo, 3 methyl, bute 1-ene. Now, let us match from options. So, if we check this first option, what is present there? If we draw expanded, what is CH double bond C? And at first carbon, what is present? Bromine. But bromine is present at which carbon? 4th. This is not possible. So, leave your option. Now, move to second. What is given here? CH2. Correct. Double bond carbon, but at second carbon, what is attached? Methyl. This is also incorrect because methyl should be present at which carbon? Third carbon. So, B option is also incorrect. Now, move to third. What is given? CH2, CH3. There, B and C, both options are given same. So, by mistake, B and C are drawn same. But if we check, let us change this C option. So, what will be answer here? This will be answer. No? 4 bromo and 3 methyl bute 1-ene. So, by mistake, option B and C are same. So, you can change this. And so, either one, this option will be considered as option number C. So, that will be the answer. Now, next is IUPAC name of the compound. A cyclic compound is given. Whenever cyclic compound is given, what we have to write? Cyclo prefix is added in this. Now, what is present here? Double bond is present. Double bond will get the higher priority. So, numbering will start from here. 1, 2, 3. At third position, which substituent is present? Methyl is present. So, it will be 3-methyl. At third position, what is present? Methyl. So, secondary prefix is completed. Now, for primary prefix, cyclic compound, what is added? Cyclo. So, 3-methyl, cyclo. Now, for 6 carbon atom, because this ring contains how many carbon atoms? 6. So, word root will be hex. And at first position, what is present? E. So, we can write cyclohexene or cyclohex 1-ene. So, if we match option, which option will match? 3-methyl cyclohexene. Option number A will be the answer. Now, let's move to next question. Now, if we take, this is question from functional group. What is given here? If we draw structure CH3 carbon, what is present? Chlorine. Double bond CH, C double bond O, OCH3. Now CH2 is not possible, OCH3. So this is the structure of the compound which is given. Now first identify which functional group it is. So if we check, this is alkyl group R, C double bond OR. So which functional group it is? Ester. Okay. Now how to write name for ester? If we write general R, C double bond OR dash. So, first we have to write name for this R dash. So, for this R dash, what is right? Alkyl. If it is CH3, methyl, C2H5, ethyl, C3H7, propyl. So, first what we have to write name of this alkyl group which is bonded with oxygen. So, R dash is alkyl. Now, this will be considered as parent chain where C double bond O is attached. So, then what we have to write? Alkane. And secondary suffix used is oid. So complete name will be alkyl alkanoid. So important is secondary suffix used for ester is oid. Clear? Now first consider this name. For CH3 what we have to write? Methyl. So what we have written? For oxygen attached with CH3, alkyl group is written. Now this is complete parent chain. And in ester, numbering of parent chain always start from C double bond O. So this will be first carbon, second carbon, third carbon and fourth carbon. Now in this parent chain, at third carbon, what is attached? Chloro, which is treated as a substituent. So what we write? 3-chloro. Now next is world root. For 4 carbon atom, what is world root? Bute. Now in this bute, what is present? Alkene is present. At which position? Second. So it will be bute. 2-ene. And next is oid. Secondary suffix. So what we have written? First name of the alkyl group which is attached with the oxygen. Then we have taken this as parent chain. C double bond OR. And numbering will always start from C double bond O. Then we have written the substituent which is present in parent chain. Which substituent is present? Chloro. So 3-chloro. For 4 carbon atom, word root is bute. Primary suffix is double bond is present. So what is written? Primary suffix is 2-ene. And for this ester, what is functional group present? Secondary suffix present? Oid. So name will be methyl 3-chlorobute 2-ene-oid. Now match from options. Which option will match? Methyl 3-chlorobute 2-ene-oid. So option A will be the answer. Now move to next. Next question is also from functional group. What is given here? CH3. Double bond CH and next is COH. So what is given here? Carboxylic acid is given. So for carboxylic acid, always numbering start from COH. 1, 2, 3, 4. At third carbon, what is present here? Methyl. 4 carbon atom word root is bute. At second carbon, double bond. And for carboxylic acid, what is suffix used? Oic acid. So name will be 3-methyl-bute-2-ene-oic acid. A match from option. 3-methyl-bute-2-ene-oic acid. So option B will be the answer. So this is easier question from functional group. Now next is, now what is present here? Two OH groups are present, which is alcohol. Now I draw again this structure, CH3, CH, OH, CH2, OH and one more CH3. Now two alcohols are present. What will be the length of parent chain? This is length of parent chain. Now next is that functional group will get the least number. So if you write numbering from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 comma 4. If you write from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 comma 4. So both are same. Next is substituent should get the least number. So from this side methyl will get number 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So at second position, first we write name of the substituent what is present, methyl. For 5 carbon atom, what will be word root? Pentane. And what is present? 2 OH groups are present at which position? Second position and fourth position. So it will be 2,4 diol. So what will be complete name for this compound? 2-methyl pentane 2,4 diol. So if we match from options, 2-methyl pentane 2,4 diol. So C option will be correct answer. Move to next question. Now this is important. Whenever carbon containing functional groups are present more than 2, then special suffix will be used. And for example, if you take this compound, how many carbon containing functional groups are present? 3. So what is parent chain? This alkane will be considered as the parent chain. And for CN, special suffix will be used, that is carbonitrile. So what is numbering? 1, 2, 3. So it will be propane. At first, second and third carbon, what is present? Carbonitrile. So it is tricarbonitrile. And similar question can be asked for carboxylic acid also. The similar question, COOH carbon containing functional group are present. So what we consider, this alkane will be considered as parent chain. Now name of compound will be propane 1,2,3 tricarboxylic acid. So what will be special suffix used here? कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड फॉर COH एंड फॉर CN व्हाट इज स्पेशल सफिक्स यूज कार्बोनाइट्राइड. सो व्हाट विल बी नेम ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड प्रोपेन 1,2,3 ट्राइकार्बोनाइट्राइड एंड दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दीज आर रिटन इन एनसीईआरटी ऑल्सो. फॉर CHO व्हाट इज यूज कार्बल्डिहाइड. सो रिमेंबर दिस व्हेनेवर कार्बन कंटेनिंग फंक्शनल ग्रुप आर प्रेजेंट मोर देन टू then some special suffix will be used and these are not considered in parent chain. Alkane will be considered as the parent chain. Now next is question from aromatic compound with benzene. What is attached here? Alkyl group is attached. So which alkyl group is attached? CH, CH3, CH3. Now what is name of this alkyl group? So if we consider CH3, CH2, CH3. Now this compound is propane. Now from propane we can draw two alkyl groups. So if we draw first alkyl group CH3, CH2, CH2, hydrogen is removed from the last carbon. So this is called as normal propyl. But if hydrogen is removed from this second carbon, then this is called as isopropyl. So remember this. In propane, how many alkyls are possible? Two alkyls are possible. One is normal propyl and one is isopropyl. So if you write name for this alkyl, what is name? This is isopropyl. So name of compound will be isopropyl and what is attached here? This is C6H6, one valency vacant, benzene. So name of compound will be isopropyl benzene. So option B will be correct. Now important is this isopropyl is a common name. If we have to write IUPAC name for this, so always numbering start from the carbon which is directly attached to the parent chain. Now at first carbon what is present? Methyl. So it is 1-methyl and for 2 carbon atom what is used? Ethyl. So isopropyl is a common name and IUPAC name is 1-methyl ethyl. And important is these common names are also considered as IUPAC because it is recommended as IUPAC name also. There is no option like 1-methyl ethyl. Option is given for isopropyl. That's why marked is answered isopropyl benzene. But if option is given 1-methyl ethyl benzene, then that is also correct. And one more name for this compound is, it is also called as cumene. This reaction you will study in method of preparation of phenol also. From cumene, but we can prepare phenol. So, one name is cumene, common name. Isopropyl benzene is also a common name. And one another name what you can write is as 1-methyl ethyl benzene. Move to next. What is present? Two rings are present. Whenever two rings or more than two rings are attached to a alkane, then ring will be treated as a substituent. And this alkane will be considered as parent chain. Yeah. And what is name of C6H5? Benzene, one valency vacant. C6H5 is called as phenyl. Now these two rings will be treated as substituents. So how many rings are attached? Two. And what is name of this cyclic compound? Phenyl. So it will be diphenyl. Two phenyl are present. And in parent chain, how many carbon atoms are present? One. For one carbon atom, what is word root? Meth. And for meth, what is possible only? Alkane. So, diphenyl methane. So, if you check where it is, D option. Diphenyl methane. This will be correct answer. So, whenever two or more rings are attached to a alkane, then rings will be treated as substituent and alkane will be considered as the parent chain. Move to next question. Again, aromatic compound having functional groups. Now, which functional groups are attached? Two functional groups. One is aldehyde, one is alcohol, and one is bromine. Which is senior functional group? Aldehyde. CHO is a senior functional group. And in aromatic compounds, where senior functional group is attached, that will be considered at first carbon atom. Now, this OH and bromine will be treated as substituent. Now, if you move here, 1, 2, 3, from here, 1, 2, 3, both are same. So, if first point of difference rule, that is lowest set of Locant rule fails, then what we have to decide from alphabetical order. Now bromo will come first or hydroxy will come first? Bromo. So more priority is given to bromo. 5, 6. Now first write name of substituent. At third carbon what is present? Bromo. At fifth carbon what is attached? Hydroxy. Okay. So these are name of substituent. Now for CHO we can write in two ways. First is benzene. For CHO directly attached what can be used? Carbaldehyde. Or in place of this benzene carbaldehyde what we can write? Benzaldehyde. Because benzene attached with CHO, that compound is benzaldehyde, or you can write this as benzene carbaldehyde. For CHO special suffix is carbaldehyde if it is directly attached with the cyclic compound. Now if we match from options, 3 bromo, 5 hydroxy, benzene, carbaldehyde, or you can write this as benzaldehyde. So option C will be the answer. Now move to next question. Now from here nomenclature is over, but we will start structural isomers. For C5H10, how many structural isomers are possible? So whenever a formula for carbon hydrogen means hydrocarbon is given, first important thing is calculate degree of unsaturation. Degree of unsaturation is also called as hydrogen deficiency index or double bond equivalent. This will be helpful to draw the structure that compound will be cyclic, how many rings are present, how many double bonds are present, how many triple bonds are present. So for DU, what is formula? Number of carbon hydrogen, carbon atom plus 1 minus hydrogen divided by 2. So 5 plus 1, 6 minus 10 divided by 2, 5. So degree of unsaturation for C5H10 is 1. Now this DU1 will indicate either one ring is present or either one double bond is present. Okay. So first we have to draw structures which contain one double bond, that is alkene. And second is we have to draw structures which contain one ring. So all these structures will be total structural isomers of C5H10. So let us start from double bond, that is alkene. 5 carbon atoms can be present in straight chain. At first carbon what is present? Double bond. Next is double bond can be present at second carbon atom, pent 1 in and pent 2 in. Next is if we take 4 carbon atoms in straight chain, that is iso, and 4 carbon, total 5 carbon atom, pentane. Double bond can be present at first position. It can be present at second position or it can be present at third position. So how many isomers of double bond are possible? 5. This is first, second, third, fourth and fifth. Next we draw for ring. So for ring, how many carbon atoms? 5 carbon atoms in parent chain. Next is 4 carbon atoms in parent chain and 1 methyl branching. Next is 3 carbon atom ring. 2 methyl branching at which position? 1, 2. Next is 2 branching at present at same carbon, 1, 1. And last structure is, which substituent is present? Ethyl C2H5. So how many open chain compounds are present? 5. How many cyclic compounds are present? 5 total possible structure. So how many total number of structural isomers are possible? 10 structural isomers are possible for C5H10. So for hydrocarbon, always first write degree of unsaturation. If degree of unsaturation is 1, it indicates that either one ring is present or one double bond. For ring, DU is 1. For one double bond, DU is 1. For triple bond, DU is 2. Move to next question. Next is number of ether isomers for compound. Formula is given C4H10O. Now, what is ether? Ether functional group is ROR. Okay. So, I will tell always simple isomers of this alkyl group which will be helpful in finding total number of structural isomers. It is very easy. For C3H7, how many isomers are possible? 2 isomers are possible. One is normal propyl, one is isopropyl. If you take C4H9, how many structural isomers are possible? 4 structural isomers are possible. Normal butyl, isobutyl, secondary butyl and tertiary butyl. And for C5H11, 8 structural isomers are possible. Only these are sufficient for alkyl. Remember this, C3H7, 2 structural isomer. C4H9, 4 structural isomer. C5H11, 8 structural isomer. Now we have to find ether of C4H10O. So let us start from one alkyl group is CH3. Oxygen. Then what is left? C3H7. For C3H7, how many isomers are possible? 2. So it means 2 structural isomers are possible for this combination. Next, if we take C2H5, oxygen C2H5. In C2H5, isomerism is not possible. Only this ethyl is possible. So only one case. Now, if you write again C3H7CH3, that will be same structure. So, how many structural isomers are possible for ether 2 plus 1? Total structural isomers are 3. Okay, so, no need to draw structures. Easily, you can write from this. Alkyl isomers for 3 carbon atom, 2 isomer. For 4 carbon atom, 4 isomer. 5 carbon atom, 8 isomer. So, for ether, what will be answer here? 3 isomers are possible. Move to next. Number of secondary amine isomer of C4H11N. Important is representation. What is representation for primary amine? RNH2. Representation for secondary amine is RNHR, means R2NH. For tertiary amine, what is representation? R3N. All alkyl groups are attached with nitrogen. Now we have to write only for secondary amine. So let us start from secondary amine. Total how many carbon atoms are present? 4. So first fix CH3. NH, what is left here? C3H7. For C3H7, how many isomers are possible? 2 structural isomers. Next will be C2H5, NH, C2H5. How many isomers are possible? 1. So, total number of isomers will be 2 plus 1, 3. Answer will be 3. I will tell you extra point about this. If there are how many primary amine are possible? For primary amine, what is RNH2? So, what to write here? C4H9. NH2. For C4H9, how many structural isomers are possible? 4. Directly answer, no need to draw. Next, if there are find tertiary amines. So, 3 alkyl groups we have to attach. CH3, nitrogen, CH3, C2H5. Only how many cases possible? 1 case is possible. No other case is possible for tertiary amine. Reason is 1 ethyl, 1 ethyl, 1 ethyl and 2 methyl. So, all 4 carbon atoms are completed. There is no other combination for tertiary amine. And for ethyl, there is no further isomerism. So, if there is total number of amines for this, what will be answer? 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 3, 8. But if they are asking only secondary amine, then what will be answer? 2 plus 1, 3. So, for this question, answer will be option B. Next is very good question from amide. Now, for amide, representation is very important. So, we will write for all primary, secondary and tertiary. Let us start from primary amide. So, it will be R or H. C double bond O NH2 with nitrogen. How many carbon atoms are attached? 1 carbon atom is attached. For secondary amide, C double bond O, either alkyl group or hydrogen. And next is nitrogen, hydrogen and one more alkyl group. If we write for tertiary amide, because we have to write tertiary amide, so it will be R or H, C double bond O, N and both are alkyl group. So how many carbon atoms are directly attached with nitrogen? That will tell about the degree of the amide. So next we have to draw only tertiary amide. So let us start from tertiary amide. What is formula? C5H11NO. So let us first fix here hydrogen. C double bond O, nitrogen. Now how many alkyl we have to attach here? 2. 1 carbon is already present, remaining carbon atom will be 4. So, 4 carbon atoms can be attached. 1 is CH3 एंड वन इज C3H7। सो काउंट टोटल कार्बन एटम 3 + 1 = 4, 4 + 1 = 5। नाउ हाउ मेनी आइसोमर्स ऑफ C3H7 आर पॉसिबल? 2। नाउ अनदर केस इन दिस वी कैन राइट HC OO नाइट्रोजन C2H5 C2H5। सो हाउ मेनी केस? ओनली वन। बोथ आर इथाइल एंड इथाइल, देर इज नो आइसोमेरिज्म, सो ओनली वन स्ट्रक्चर इज पॉसिबल। नेक्स्ट, इन प्लेस ऑफ हाइड्रोजन व्हाट वी कैन राइट? CH3। नाउ नाइट्रोजन, टोटल हाउ मेनी कार्बन एटम? 5। 2 आर ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट, सो रिमेनिंग आर 3 कार्बन एटम, सो इट विल बी CH3 C2H5। सो 2, 3, 4, 5। नाउ इन C2H5 देर इज नो आइसोमेरिज्म, सो ओनली वन स्ट्रक्चर पॉसिबल। नेक्स्ट, इफ वी राइट C2H5 C OO CH3 CH3, सो ओनली हाउ मेनी स्ट्रक्चर आर पॉसिबल? 1। बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट राइट एयर C3H7, बिकॉज इफ वन हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट दैट विल नॉट बी टर्शियरी अमाइड, इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू विच अमाइड? सेकेंडरी। So only these are possible case for tertiary amide. So if we count 2 + 1 = 3, 3 + 1 = 4, 4 + 1 = 5. So total how many isomers are possible for tertiary amide? 5 isomer. Now it is not necessary always they ask only tertiary amide. They can ask primary, they can ask secondary or total number of amides. So always you have to write from the general representation and then count total number of structural isomers from alkyl isomers. Move to next question. Next is from geometrical isomerism. Now for geometrical isomerism, what is first condition? If we talk about condition for geometrical isomerism, first condition is there will be restricted rotation. What is meaning of restricted rotation? Either a double bond is present or a ring is present. Second is different groups are attached. Groups are attached at site of restricted rotation. So where site of restricted rotation, different groups will be attached to that atom. And third is orbital should be in same plane. Should be in same plane. So if these three conditions are satisfied, then compound will show geometrical isomerism. So let us start from first. What is present here? Double bond is present, but both hydrogen are present. So it will not show geometrical isomerism. Same groups are attached. Same here, if you take here double bond, hydrogen, hydrogen, same group are present. Now start from here. What is present? One is hydrogen and one is chlorine. Different. From here, carbon, what is present? CH2, CH2. Next is CH2, CH2. Next is CH. So both substituents are same. If both substituents are same, geometrical isomerism is not possible. Next is, if we consider this double bond, hydrogen, chlorine, what is present here? CH2. Here also CH2. Next is CH2. Here what is present? CH. So both substituents are different. So this will show geometrical isomerism. So every time first and second condition are important. Third condition we have to check in case of spiro compounds, in case of cumulenes. So their third point is required that orbital should be present in the same plane. Next question is that how many geometrical isomers are possible for this compound? Now for geometrical isomers, first, we have to find out the site at which geometrical isomerism is possible. So, if we consider this carbon double bond nitrogen. On nitrogen, what is present? One lone pair, one OH, different group. For carbon, one hydrogen and one this cyclic substituent. So, here geometrical isomerism is possible. And second site is if you consider this ring. Because if you write a ring here, what is present? AA. So one hydrogen. So on this side also what is possible? Geometrical isomerism is possible along the ring. So here geometrical isomerism is possible. So how many sites are there where geometrical isomerism are possible? 2. And this is a case of molecule having dissimilar ends. So formula for total number of geometrical isomers is 2 to the power n, where n is stereogenic area where geometrical isomerism is possible. So how many sites are there? 2. So 2 to the power 2, what is answer? 4. So 4 geometrical isomers are possible for this compound. Move to next question. Next is, which of the following is not a chiral, means where chiral center is not present. So if we consider chiral center, what is meaning of chiral center? So chiral center is sp3 hybridized atom having 4 different substituents. So that atom will be considered as chiral atom, or you can say chiral center. So if we draw structure for these compounds, let us draw for butaneol, 2-butanol, CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH3. Now if you find this carbon is sp3 hybridized and how many substituents are attached? 4, and all are different. One methyl, one is OH, one is hydrogen, one is ethyl. So it contains chiral center. So A cannot be the answer. Next is 2,3-dibromopentane. So if we write pentane, CH3, CH, bromine, CH, bromine, CH2, CH3. So 5 carbon atom and second and third contains bromo. Now if you consider this set, sp3 hybridized, one hydrogen, bromo, methyl and one this alkyl group, chiral center, and this is also chiral center, one hydrogen, bromo, ethyl and one bromo ethyl. So all 4 different substituents, so it contains how many chiral center? 2 chiral center. So this cannot be answer. Now let us move to third option, 3-bromopentane. CH3, CH2, CHBr, CH2, CH3. Now, if you consider, there is no chiral center in this compound, because if you consider this carbon, both substituent attached are ethyl. So here no chiral center is present. So which will be answer? Option C will be the answer. If you draw fourth structure, what is written? Propanoic acid at second carbon, what is present? Hydroxy. So CH3, CH, OH, COOH, it also contains chiral center. So which does not contain chiral center? That is 3-bromopentane. And you, for this you have to remember definition of this chiral center, that sp3 hybridized atom having 4 different substituents is called as chiral center. Move to next question. Next, what is written? A compound is given and what we have to find out? RS configuration along chiral center. What is chiral center here? This is chiral center. At carbon, hydrogen, one is chlorine, one is methyl and one is ethyl. This is chiral center. Now for chiral center, what we have to find out? Which is a R configuration. RS configuration means it is an absolute configuration for any chiral center. Now to find RS configuration, first is we have to give priority according to which rule? CIP rule. CIP rule is based on the atomic number. Have more the atomic number, higher will be the priority of that group. So if we give priorities to these groups, so first we write priorities for all. Now carbon, chlorine, carbon, hydrogen, which is having higher atomic number? Chlorine. Next, first atom carbon, carbon same. Next, carbon attached with hydrogen. Here carbon attached with carbon. So C2H5 will get higher priority, CH3, and hydrogen will get 4. So it means according to this CIP rule, what is priority? Chlorine. Next is ethyl, methyl, and last is hydrogen. Now I am writing rule. If fourth priority is at vertical position. Yeah, if fourth priority is at vertical position and you move 1, 2, 3 in clockwise direction, then it is R configuration. And on going from 1, 2, 3 anti-clockwise, it will give S configuration. And if fourth priority is at horizontal, this will be reverse. Clockwise will be considered as S, anti-clockwise will be considered as R. Now let us move to A option. Now leave fourth, 1, 2, 3. We are moving clockwise or anti-clockwise? It is clockwise. So when you move clockwise and fourth priority is at horizontal. So this configuration will be S configuration. So this is not answer. Now move to B option, fluoro, then C2H5. And fourth is hydrogen. Now if we move 1, 2, 3, where we are moving clockwise or anti-clockwise? This is clockwise. Now when we move clockwise and fourth priority is at which position? This one, vertical position, clockwise means which configuration? R configuration. If you check C option, 1, 2, 3 and this is 4. Now again, but we are moving clockwise. So clockwise at fourth horizontal position, which configuration? S configuration. Here chloro, C2H5, CH3, 4, 1, 2, 3. But we are moving anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise at fourth position, vertical, which configuration? S configuration. So A, C and D are which configuration? S. And B is which configuration? R. So what is answer? Option B. RS configuration is very important topic. So important is, first you have to give priority according to CIP rule, which is based on the atomic number. Move to next question. Among which of the following compound which can have a mesoform? Now what is meaning of mesoform? Compound which has chiral center and also have, next thing is plane of symmetry or any symmetric element. Or simply we can say, let us say how many chiral center are present? 2. All substituents will be same. You know, ABC, here also ABC. So it contains plane of symmetry. So this type of compound is called as which compound? Meso compound. So meso compound is optically inactive due to internal compensation. Because one chiral center, if it is dextro, then another will be levo. So net rotation will become zero. So compound will become optically inactive. So if we draw structure, now condition is two chiral center and on both chiral center, all substituents will be same. A, B, C, here also A, B and C. Now match from this first. What you find? 1 OH, 1 chlorine. Not possible. Next, if we move to B option, CH3, CHOH, CHOH, CH3. So what you find? How many chiral center are present? 2 chiral center. At first chiral center, which substituents are present? Hydrogen, OH and CH3. Here also hydrogen, OH and CH3. So this will satisfy this condition. 2 chiral center, all substituents are same. So for this compound, what is possible? Mesoform is possible. Total how many isomers will be there? 3 isomers, out of which 2 are optically active and 1 is meso. Now 1 R, R, this will be optically active. S, S, optically active. 1 R, 1 S, this compound will be called as which compound? Meso compound. So in which of the following mesoform is possible? In option B, mesoform is possible. Move to next question. How many stereoisomers are there for tartaric acid? So this is very easy question. Only you have to remember structure of tartaric acid. What is CH? OH, COH. CH, OH and COH. So if you check how many chiral centers are present? 2 chiral centers. So if 2 chiral centers are present, what are possible cases? R, R. Next possible case, S, S. Next is R and S. So, 2 are optically active and this RS is optically inactive, means which compound it is? Meso compound. So, meso, same 2 chiral center, all 3 substituents are same. So, 1 form will be meso and 2 are optically active. So, total how many isomers are possible? 3 isomers are possible. You can apply formula also for symmetrical ends. But it is not required if only 2 chiral center are present. Very easy to identify. Both are R configuration, both are S configuration, 1 R and 1 S configuration. Move to next. How many stereoisomers? Now this is question for complete geometrical plus optical. So one structure is given. If we expand this structure, CH3, CH, next is CH2, OH and COOH. Now, if we have to find total number of stereoisomers, we have to find out the site where geometrical and optical isomerism is possible. Now consider this site. What is possible here? Geometrical isomerism, different substituent H, CH3, H in this group. Now this is chiral center. All 4 substituents are different, H, OH, COH and one this group, alkyl group. So one chiral center, one side for geometrical isomerism. What is total value of n is equal to 2. And for unsymmetrical molecule, total number of stereoisomers are 2 to the power n. So what is answer? 2 to the power 2, 4. So option D will be the answer. So for unsymmetrical molecule, always we have to apply this 2 to the power n. So this is all about isomerism and nomenclature. Yeah, so you can subscribe this channel. Reason you will get daily videos for this NEET revision program. And then you can join Telegram group also. There you will get some quiz, some more questions on that. So students, thank you for today. We'll meet in next class.